and traveling on the Merlion route. You are now cruising in the Singapore River, the center of trade for this nation from 1819 until the later half of the 20th century. Trading was done in Boat Quay and here at Clark Quay was where traders stored their goods. All the conservation buildings flanking both sides of the river were once warehouses. It was then common to see suntanned coolies balancing heavy gunny sacks on their shoulders, loading and unloading a wide range of goods. Straight ahead is the Lit Up Reed Bridge, named after prominent resident William Reed. In the past, laborers and boat rowers would gather every evening at the open space on the left hand of the bridge to listen to animated Kyushu storytellers, a common form of entertainment in those days. This area was called Chor Chun Hau in Kyushu, a reference to the boats that carried firewood from Indonesia to the shops that sold them there. Kyushu is a Chinese island spoken by early immigrants from Guangdong, China. The Kyushu clan is known for controlling the firewood trade. Piles of firewood used to line the streets in this area. Now the same streets are lined by various al fresco waterfront restaurants. to the Elgin Bridge. Completed in 1929, this was once the only place where you could walk across the Singapore River. There were two roads leading to it, predictably named Northbridge Road and Southbridge Road. On our left, at a distance, the building of our saucer-like roof cabin is the new Supreme Court, and the Colonial Building, the Classic Home, and the old Supreme Court. Emerging from Elgin Bridge on the left is the Parliament House, followed by the old Parliament House. Since the cabinet moved to the new building in 1999, the old Parliament House has been converted to an art house. Looking for a swimming good time? Head on down to Bo Key on your right. Conserved shop houses are now transformed into a mix of fine and alfresco dining, lively bars, and pubs. Hugging the side of the riverbank, the light from each eatery brightens up the river at night. After the shop houses are swanky buildings in the central business district. It houses three of the tallest buildings in Singapore. The UOB, OUB, and Republic Plaza are all standing equal at 280 meters. Please feel free to leave your seats, walk to the front of the boat, and enjoy 360 degrees of unobstructed view at the viewing gallery. On your left is the Historical Civic District. The Hanson Building is Asian Civilizations Museum. Behind the museum is the clock tower, a Victoria Theater, and a concert hall. Suspension bridge in Singapore. It is also the oldest bridge on the island that exists in its original form. Cavenagh Bridge linked the Civic District to the Commercial District. Before Cavenagh Bridge was constructed, the people could only get to the two districts via a detour over Elgin Bridge or by paying for a boat ride across the river. On the right, just before the bridge, are life-size cast iron sculptures of traders and yesteryears. Look out for more life-size sculptures as you walk along the riverbank. On the other side of Cavenagh Bridge are sculptures of a group of exuberant boys leaping in for a swim, but eternally suspended in the air. Installed in 2000 and called the First Generation, they've become a favorite tour spot. The magnificent Colonnade building, beautifully lit on the right, is the Fullerton Hotel. Built in 1928, it was once the Colonial Post Office, World War II hospital, and headquarters of the Japanese military during Japanese occupation. Coming up is the 100-year-old Anderson Bridge. This bridge is now part of the F1 Singapore Grand Prix Marina Bay Street circuit. During the night race, this grand old dame is lit up with all of its intricate details shining bright. Straight ahead is the Esplanade Bridge. Sitting just behind it on the left is the Esplanade Theater. The roof of the Esplanade is made up of 7,000 variously angled aluminum shades. In the day, they maximize natural lighting and reduce greenhouse effect. that night, the internal light is set to the minimum. It is this brilliant rooftop that locals nickname it the Dirty. We are now at the mouth of Sinapore River and entering into the Marina Bay.
On our right is the Merlion Park. The Merlion has a head of a lion and the body of a fish. Designed by Fraser Bruner for the Tourism Board in 1964, it is Singapore's tourism icon. The fish body comes from the word Temasek, Singapore's ancient name back when it was a fishing village. The lion head represents the lion spotted by Prince Sang Nila Utama when he rediscovered Singapura in 11 AD. This Merlion statue was created in 1972 by a Singaporean craftsman. At 8.6 meters high and 40 tons, the Merlion statue has a body of cement, skin of porcelain plates, and eyes of small red teacups. Right where it's sitting now, the Merlion was struck by lightning in February 2009 and underwent some repairs. Now this is a postcard perfect spot for the Singapore cityscape. We'll be stopping here for just a short while. Feel free to move around and put your camera to use.
This stretch is one Fullerton, and it is a popular haunt for alfresco dining at night. One Fullerton is connected to the Fullerton Hotel behind by an underpass. The height of one Fullerton's perks are kept low to ensure the historical Fullerton building continues to be visible from Marina Bay. Straight ahead, The structure with the red roof is completely clear. It was a landing point for immigrants and other sea passengers any and every day. Marked for conservation, it underwent renovation and is now a restaurant. We are now in the Marina Bay. Eatery along this stretch is One Fullerton, and it is a popular haunt for al fresco dining at night. One Fullerton is connected to the Fullerton Hotel behind by an underpass. The height of One Fullerton is purposely kept low to ensure the historical Fullerton building continues to be visible from Marina Bay. Straight ahead, the structure with a red roof is Clifford Pier. It was a landing point for immigrants and other sea passengers in the early day. Marked for conservation, it underwent renovation and is now a restaurant. We are now in the Marina Bay. This area has been earmarked to be a lifestyle hub with round-the-clock activity. It would consist of residential, office, and commercial developments, as well as various entertainment outlets and attractions. Upcoming developments in the Bay Area include the Integrated Resort Marina Bay Sands, Double Helix Bridge, Marina Financial Center, Gardens by the Bay, and an International Cruise Terminal. The Marina Bay is now a reservoir with a damming at the mouth of the Marina Channel. This will provide another source of drinking water for sampling, and the barrage will help prevent floodings in the lowland Chinatown area. Straight ahead are the multi-colored seats of the Marina Bay Floating Stadium and the iconic Singapore Flyer. Tickets for the Flyer are available. Simply approach our friendly crew at the Clark Quay Jetty. Here's a panoramic view of Marina Bay Hotels. Structure is the last classical architecture building erected in Singapore.